Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I want to share with you how to handle last minute design changes to your website easily with Wix Studio. Quick reminder, I share everything about UX on my YouTube channel, from design tips, portfolio reviews, the latest tools and technology. If you're interested on this type of topic, please feel free to hit the subscribe so you won't miss any of my future content. Have you ever run into a dilemma when you're ready to hand off your website, but a client wants to make some last minute changes? Instead of spending hours or days to change and rebuild everything, I will cover site styles, Photo Studio AI tools, and some advanced features in Wix Studio to help you manage change efficiently, no matter how complex or sudden the ask is. So here we're looking at an e-commerce website of a back shop. Just when I saw the site was almost ready, the client sent a list of things that they wanted to make changes. So the first request was to change their brand colors. How do we do that? Let's go into the editor mode. Okay, so now we're in the editor mode. To make those changes, you know, one way what we can do is, of course, to change the color of a button. You can select the button, going to the right side of the inspector. So here you can change the color of the button view. If I were going to manually change those colors from the headline text to the button across the whole website, that's probably going to take me several hours. So instead, to do a global change of the site style, what you can do is look at the left menu, and here there's a button called Site Styles. So once you tap onto the Site Styles, you will see the tab for all, colors, typography, max width, and page transitions. So this is where you can easily manage color themes across the website. Let me show you an example. Here, my client was asking me to change the main primary color of the headline buttons to an olive green. What you can do is select the color 6, input the exact hex number. There you go, and click apply. Let's go into the preview mode. As you see, with that one quick change, all the headline, titles, and button colors have changed. And this is how you can easily manage the theme colors of a website easily from the site styles. Now let's go back to the editor mode. Another item on the request list from my client is to get rid of the banner here. It was a temporary style, which we don't need anymore. So of course you can delete this section, but in case you will need to bring this back in future, what you can do is select this section and go into layers, where you will see this is the announcement section. And on the right hand, there is the three-dot menu for more actions. You can tap onto that, and there's an option to hide it. So I'm just gonna click hide. There you go. So we just removed this sales banner easily, but at the same time, in future, if it ever comes back that the client wants to bring this banner back, oh, you can always go back to layers and unhide this section. Okay, the clients also want to change the hero image. As the summer season is coming, the client want to show more of a summer vibe, and also the client want to add some more personality to the product image. As of now, it's just a solid color feel of the background. So let's see what we can do. So first of all, to change this hero image, what you can do is select the image and click change image. From here, you can either upload your own media or export media from Wix, Shutterstock, or Unsplash. So I just find an image that I like that shows more of a summer vibe. I'm gonna adjust the height a little bit. Perfect. Now, let's take a look at a product image. So right now, this image is basically just a model, showcase the bag with a solid background feel. I wanted to add a little bit more of a personal touch to change the background of this image. And here what you can do is first to select this image, and then you can click this settings button. Here you will see this button called adjust. So just go ahead and click on that. And this will bring you to the Photo Studio. Within the Photo Studio, there are many adjustments you can make for this picture, from crop extend, adjust the light and colors, apply filters, erase any object. There's also AI image editor tool, and that you can regenerate things, doing cutout, apply text, decorative effects, overlays, and background. So in my case, first of all, I want to get like a cutout of the model here. Let's click on cutout. There you go. We get the background removed. If you are not quite happy with the result, you can always click refine cutout, where you will have these options to restore, erase, or fix edges of the object. The next step, I want to select a background for this image. So you can tap on background. Here, instead of adjust the solid fill colors, you can explore the image or apply textures and even use like a stage or illustrations. So for here, I'm just gonna use this image to add a bit more interest to this picture. Happy with that? So I'm gonna click on save. Another image I want to change is this one. You know, as you see, this is also an image that doesn't have any background. It's just using a color fill. So I'm gonna go ahead and click on settings and go into adjust so I can get into the photo studio mode. I'm gonna do the cutout. There you go. Want to make some adjustment to refine the cutout. I'm just gonna use the fixed edges. You get this little brush, you can adjust the size to make it smaller and to fine tune some of the areas that I think the cutout was not that perfect for the model's hair. And at any time, you can use this button to preview the changes. That's much better. Cool. Now I'm gonna go switch to background. I'm gonna explore some image. Let's try this one. I think the color looks really nice. It has some decorations in the background, which doesn't really take the main focus of the picture. Let's click save. With just a few minutes, we were able to change the hero image and adding more interest to the product image here. Okay, the next thing is the client wants to change all the titles to be all caps. Of course, one way you can do that is to go ahead and select the text element, use the inspector on the right hand to manually change this by typing it. But an easier way to do that, once you have this tag select, you have this option here under capitalization, where you can simply switch the title case to uppercase. There we go. Now, another request I got here is to change the font. Okay, let's go into the site styles. So currently, if we look into typography, we have Helvetica as the main font. The client liked this font, but wanted to change it to make the site feel more modern. So typically when you need to change the text font, of course you can select the text element and go into the inspector to change the font over here. But here in this scenario, instead of making change to one specific text element, the client request was to change all the font across the web. What I would recommend you to do is go into the site styles, switch the tab to typography. So to make the global change of all the font across the web, we can select the current font and switch it to the font that you like. There you go. So with just a few clicks, all the text on this website, from headlines to titles to the font and the buttons, are all switched to the new font. Instead of making individual change to certain specific element, this is a much more efficient way when you need to change the style, the color, or the font across your website. Okay, so another request I got here is the client want to add a section for the new summer collections. How do we do that? We're looking at a landing page, and the area that the client wanted to add it is right below the bestsellers. So here we can tap on this add section. You have the options to choose between design section, grid layout, or add an element. Here I'm gonna just do add an element. What I'm hoping to do is choose a hero image with an overlaying text on top of it. So let's see, media. I'm gonna select like a full-width image. When you select the image, so you can choose stretch to let the image fill the whole space. So here I'm just gonna choose this image that reflecting summer vibe with the surfing board. There's one feature I really like about Wix Studio is you can add simple animations to text very easily. By clicking on add elements and go into text, there is an option for text mask. So here, as you see, it's a collection of text masks that has the text overlaying on top of the image or video. I'm gonna just go ahead and select the first one. And you can click on Change Text to input your own text. Summer Collection, there we go. And I want to make sure it is aligned to the center. To change the layer behind the text, you can select the text and go into the inspector where under Design View, this is where you can change the media. So I'm gonna go ahead, click on that, switch that to a video that I like. Let's go to the preview mode and take a look. As you see, here we have created a section for Summer Collection. Now that we have created this text mask, I want to make sure that we have a call to action button. So I'm just gonna go ahead and click one of the Shop Now button to copy and paste it. There we go. Okay, now let's go back to the preview mode and take a look. We have just created this new hero image on the landing page to feature the summer collection. And we have used this text mask feature to add some more visual interest to this headline of summer collection. Let's take a quick look of the final website here. To wrap it up, we have addressed all the client's requests by using site styles, photo studio AI tools, capitalization features. We were able to adjust the site styles, including color, typography, very easily. And we were also able to change the image and created a new section for summer collection with some fun text mask effect with just a few minutes. We have covered a lot today. If you want to learn more about Wix Studio, feel free to check out Wix Studio Academy. There are a lot of amazing learning resources that can help you learn advanced skills and dive deeper in Wix Studio. Like I always say, the best way to learn is to practice. If you're ready to transform your website game, click the link below to experience Wix Studio and start creating today. If you have any questions or comments, please feel free to share with me. I would love to hear from you. I will see you next time. Bye.